There are many things in life we cannot control. We cannot control the weather, despite what Sat Window will say. We cannot control Congress. We can't control the weather. But there is one thing that we can control, and that is what we put in our mouth. Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and no guests. An iPhone changed my life back in 2012. And how did that happen? Paul Bruniforte came to my office one day as a coach. I think I was his first non-paying client. He said to me, "What are some of your goals?" And one of my goals was to do 10 push-ups. And he says, "Why don't you do the push-ups?" And the first thing that came out of my mouth was, "I don't have time." Paul brought out his iPhone and says, "Start the clock." He did 30 push-ups in 15 seconds. And he gets up and he looks at me and he says, "And you don't have the time." That right there changed my life. The reason for that is I decided I wanted to do 10 push-ups. I got down on the ground and I struggled with 10 push-ups, but I did it. And then each day I would add one more push-up to my program. And I got to one of my goals. And one of my goals was to do 50 push-ups when I hit 55 years old. And that was April of 2013. And I hit that goal in February. I did 50 push-ups. My goal then was to do 100 push-ups. And today I can sit here and tell you that I did 110 push-ups without stopping. So when 2013 came around, I wanted to take my workout to another level. And I hired a trainer. His name is Michael Salgado. Mary knows Michael. He comes to my house three times a week back in 2013, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Last year, I cut it back to just Mondays and Wednesdays. So he comes to my house every morning on Mondays and Wednesdays at 6:30 to 7:30 in the morning, and we do our workout. And I started out doing a workout because he asked me, "What kind of equipment do you have?" And I started out with this little thing. And I would put this under my feet and I would just do this. And that's all I would do with him, is start out doing small little exercises. In fact, he said, "What kind of weights do you have?" And I started out with these little 5-pounders. And I worked my way up from 5-pounders all the way up to 65-pounders. And this is something that I do Mondays and Wednesdays, is I lift this type of weight. And then I ran across a device on Facebook called the Helm, H-E-L-M. Look it up on the internet. It's this device right here. And this device has taken my push-ups to another level. And I'll demonstrate how this works. And when I start out with my exercise, the first thing that I do with this device is I do 30 push-ups like this. And I'll do 30 push-ups, and then I'll switch over here and do 30 more. This is the best little device. It's light, it's strong, and it gets results. And what I'm here today is to try to motivate you. Because I've been told my whole life, the older we get, the less muscle we have. So I have put on at least 10 pounds of muscle over these last few years. And I will continue for the rest of my life, as long as I can lift weights, to continue to do this. So I decided to go out and take it up even a further level. And I bought this device right here. Now understand, when I started out, these are considered by the pound. These are 40 pounders. So when you're lifting weight, the rubber band represents 40 pounds. I have since then, in the last 6 years, gone to 270 pounds. And that's what this thing is equivalent to. And the way this rubber band works is you can add rubber bands. So I've gone up to the max, almost the max. I need to change out the yellow to another black. But I wrap this around my bench press, and Michael has to hold on to the bench press which has 600 pounds on it, and I pull these rubber bands back as far as I can, and we'll do maybe 1 to 3 sets of those. And the first time that I did this, I just couldn't pull that back as far as I wanted to. And now, when I pull this back, Michael has to hold on to that bar because I will pull the whole 600 pounds back at me. Why am I doing this? Why am I telling you this? Because a program can start out very light. You don't have to start out with heavy weights. I certainly didn't. Now, I've been lifting weights since I was 18 years old, but there was about a 20-year period where I stopped lifting weights, and I ate a lot of food. And one of the things that I decided to do back in 2012 and 2013 was to write down my food consumption. And that's so important. If you're looking to lose 5, 10, 15 pounds, I recommend you keep a diary of what you eat and have somebody accountable to you that you can send your food log to them once a week. I was doing it daily for a long time. I was sending my food log. Now, there are days I cheated, and there'll be days you'll cheat too, but write it down. I had a Snickers bar. I had a donut. Now, those things I don't eat anymore, but if you're conscious about what you're eating and you're writing it down, it'll trigger something in you. Now, Paul is a believer that you could work out all you want, you're not going to lose weight, and that is true. It's a 90-10 rule. That means 90% of what you eat represents your body. Only 10% is from lifting weights and doing exercise. So I call it a 90-10 rule. However, I have proven to him that if you work out, if you run, if you walk, you're going to be conscious about what you eat. Because you're not going to work out for a half an hour or an hour and come home from the gym and eat a hamburger. You're not going to do that. So it really triggers your mind. Exercise is a program that I developed in 2012 for me. It's only for me. It works for me. I would recommend if you would like to start a program, I would certainly be willing to help you. Michael Salgado will come to your house. He'll give you a couple of days of training. He won't charge you anything. He'll just set up a program for you. Now, the program could be that you want to work out once a week, and then you'll do the rest of the workout maybe 2 or 3 times. So what I would encourage you to do is maybe have Michael come over to your house. He'll set up a program for you, start the program with him, and then you can develop your own program. He can come over once a week for you. It's not that expensive. I currently pay him about $400 a month, and I've been doing it for 6 years. You can do the math. But for me, it's worth it because it has changed my life. Now I'd like to do a Q&A, see if you have any questions. We'll turn the light back over to green, and we'll do some questions. Yes, Jason.
I actually know Mike. He's been coming to our house. And so I agree with what you have to say, especially about the food. My question is, what's the biggest benefit over that versus just like having a gym membership, would you say?
What the biggest benefit for me is, if I went to the gym, and many of you go to the gym, having somebody pushing you, that is really what did it for me. There's no way I would do 65 pounders like this without Michael coming over and setting up a program for me. I wouldn't do it, so he pushes me. And after he leaves, during my exercise, I'm miserable because it is a lot of work. But when he leaves, you get that feeling of accomplishment, and it makes you feel so good inside that you accomplished something. Whether it's 30 minutes or an hour, it doesn't matter. It's all up in this brain here. And I've been a runner my whole life. Ever since I got married back in 1978, I've been running ever since, and I'll continue to run. But this exercise, yeah, there's a story that goes behind that one. The point I'm trying to make is start somewhere. You can start with 5 pounders. It doesn't matter where you start. It's all about starting a program. What other questions do we have? Yes, Travis.
So I use FitnessPal to log what I eat over the last couple of years, but I find I'll go through a period where like 4 months, I'm logging everything I eat, and then I get sick of it, and I stop logging anything for like the next 6 months. So how do you find a balance of being obsessive about what you're eating and not paying attention at all?
Logging food is not a permanent thing. It just gets you in a habit. We have all heard that it takes 21 days to form a habit. And that's what he did. Now, if you look at Travis, he's in pretty darn good shape. So obviously, he's eating the right foods. So Travis, to answer your question, my recommendation is look at your weight, see where you want to be, and if you creep up 4 or 5 pounds, go back to logging for a few weeks, and then you get you right back down again. Yes, Gary?
Does your wife do the same program?
Yes, Susie does it on Wednesdays. So she does a program every Wednesday with Michael. So when Michael comes over from 6:30 to 7, she'll work out with Michael, and then from 7 to 7:30, I'll work out with Michael. So she's doing it one day a week. I'm doing it two times a week. But Susie's doing 10,000 steps a day, and she's done it now. It'll be a year come this April that she has done 10,000 steps. I think she only missed 5 days in the last year of hitting 5,000 steps, which is roughly about 5 to 7 miles. And I will tell you, Susie at 11 o'clock at night will walk around the house to get her 10,000 steps. I got time for one more question. Yes.
Would you be able to stick with this if you didn't have the accountability? I'm just curious that you've been doing it for so many years and in your life in general.
I would, because one thing that I do is occasionally when I do go out of town, I will take some of this equipment with me. But this helm right here is an amazing tool. It has changed my way of doing push-ups. Gary just flashed the light. So thank you, everyone. Appreciate it.